nobody like you. Everybody testify to what you do. You are good, you know why you love me. Lord, shout hallelujah! This is the second Sunday of the month of October. We go to appreciate the Almighty God. Shout a big hallelujah! And the life hallelujah! Amen. Many people were alive last week. Today they are no more. It's by the grace of God we are here. So make sure you appreciate the Almighty God every minute of your life. Let's take our Hebrew as we open to in 377. In 377 page 123. In 377 page 123. Say, my hope is built on nothingness than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest way, but only lean on Jesus' name. On Christ, the solid rock I stand, all other grounds is sinking sand. Thank you. prepare the Lord your faith that you stand on him, the rock of ages. The rock of ages. Say, oh, on Christ, the solid rock I stand. All of that ground are city sand. Are you standing on that solid rock? Begin to thank him. Begin to thank him because it's for you. And we'll be with you to the end.
I can't hear you say anything. I stand on Christ as a solid rock. All other ground are shaking sand. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. I want to concentrate. Today is what I call a business masterclass. And for those of you that are listening to us through the YouTube and Facebook, Brother Kenneth Godson on Facebook, Brother Monday or Sanimen on Facebook, when I was watching the Facebook, I saw those things before I left. Please listen with rapt attention. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. I want somebody to tell us what we're here to discuss this morning. Yes? Yes, can somebody tell me what we're here to talk this morning? Wow. Closer, I say, oh Lord, my Father, come and forgive me the sin of my seriousness. In the mighty name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray. Come and forgive us the sin of our seriousness. Talk to God Almighty that God should forgive you that sin of our seriousness. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Please, I want to encourage you, every week post on the social media, go and look at it. If it's an article that is fighting in the movie, you'll be gossiping about it, but something there you can. It's not a loving matter. It's not what? It's not a loving. You are coming to the church of God so that your life can change. You are coming to the church of God so that you can be better than people that are not coming to the house of God. The house of God is meant for the betterment of your life. If your life is not better, you have to check your own story. You have to look at yourself. Some now, they will be coming late. Some, they have nonchalant attitude to what we are doing. And they be complaining. Praise the name of the Lord. You don't join VG. Praise the name of the Lord. And you are not in the church. Something is wrong. That's why I pray God will forgive you in the mighty name of Jesus. Now, I open my Bible to the book of Isaiah chapter 22. Isaiah chapter 22. Isaiah chapter 22. I'm reading verse number 22. Are we there? Isaiah chapter 22, verse 22. It says, Isaiah chapter 22. Make sure you are there. It says, and the key of the house of David when I lay upon his students, so shall it shall open and none shall shut, and it shall shut and none shall open. Praise the name of the Lord. Note that scriptures. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse number 9. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse number 9. First Corinthians chapter 16, verse number 9. I read, for a great door and effectual is open unto me, and there are many adversaries. Let God open doors of generational wealth for us. You are saying amen, but you cannot remember. Praise the name of the Lord. All the negative news that will still come, but they are coming late. If they are going to family meeting, they will not go late. And I say it, if you are coming to the house of God and are not working for God, you are the enemy of the cross. No matter who you are. We have to say the truth, no matter whose ox is God. Brothers and sisters, God speaks of opportunities. God speaks of what? God speaks of chances. God speaks of possibilities. We heed good fortunes when good doors are open. What did I say? What did I say? We heed good fortunes when what? Good doors are open. Good doors shall be opened unto me in the name of Jesus. Say to yourself, because I don't know, if you cannot remember what I've been posting for weeks, the one we are going to post for VG, you don't remember. I doubt it. Good doors will be opened unto me in the mighty name of Jesus. I said, when you hit good doors, fortunes will open. He said, a great and effectual door is open unto me, but there are so many adversities. You can also read the book of Revelation chapter 3, verse number 8 and 18. Praise the name of the Lord. Make sure you go and read those things when you get to. The difference between struggling and favor is that it's what we call doors. Everybody is praying for a season of open doors. And this season, doors shall be opened unto me in the mighty name of Jesus. Doors shall be opened unto me in the mighty name of Jesus. Despite of your age, you need open doors. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Alexander Graham Bell, he was the man that discovered telephone. He made a quote which I want to read right now. Alexander Graham Bell discovered telephone. He said, when one door closes, another door opens. But we often so look so long and so regretfully upon the closed door that we do not see the ones which open for us. I read that again. Alexander Graham Bell says, when one door closes, another door opens. But we often so regretfully look upon the closed door that we do not see what the ones that are open. When a particular door, it could be a door of unemployment. Maybe you have been sacked in your place of work. You look at the door of that door that is closed so regretfully, you are not looking at the other one that is about to be opened. It could be a door of courtship or a door of dating that closed also. You look at it so much and then you cannot see the one God is opening for you. So this is a business master class and I want to encourage you to listen so much attentively. Brothers and sisters, the events of the year 2020, they have created a momentum in people's lives. Praise the name of the Lord. They have created a new way of movement. A lot of people across the planet, they are waking up today and they are taking control of their future. Say, I am waking up today. I am taking control of my future. Say it 3 more times. That one is for you. Amen. Don't deceive yourself. Listen. Sister at the back, Sister Jennifer, are you hearing me?
I am waking up today. I am taking control of my future.
That one is still for you. It goes on where? The way I shout, I say, I am waking up today. I am taking control of my future. Say that 3 times. You need to wake up so as to put an end to what you are relying on that is not supporting you well. It could be your job, it could be your business. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Brothers and sisters, we need to face it. There has never been a more important time in life to step up and take action. Praise the name of the Lord. This is the time to step up and do what? Take action. I don't want to be left behind. I don't want to be left behind. I don't know about you. There is no any better time for you to step up and take action so that you are not left behind. I refuse to be left behind. People are already stepping up. They have woken up and they are taking action. They don't want to be left behind. The journey has started. I refuse to be left behind. You are just saying this psychedelically. I want to talk like a champion. I refuse to be left what? Behind. That is one thing you must do. Brothers and sisters, what really matters at the end of the day is how big we show up. How big we do what? How big we are able to show up. The events of the few months back, when they locked down over the world, brothers and sisters, it's time for you to wake up. It's time to do what? And step up and say, look, I am not going to be left behind. I am not going to be left behind. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise Jesus. So if you want to be left behind, please keep on sleeping. Do nothing. And then, at the end of the day, I pray you will not regret in Jesus' name. You see, I want to take a quote from what the man called Jeff Percy, the founder of Amazon. He said, when I am 80 and reflecting back, I want to minimize the number of regrets that I have in my life. If you want to minimize the number of regrets you have in your life, raise up your hand. I am quoting Amazon founder, the richest man in the world. This is a business master class. Ironically, maybe some people are just hooking up onto their, what to call it, their YouTube, it's okay. If your Facebook, it's okay. If it's also Zoom, it's okay. Praise the name of the Lord. But what is most important, if you have the opportunity of coming here and you are staying back, you are cutting off yourself. We move on. What did I say? God is in this place. What did I say? I am quoting the founder of Amazon. Because this is a time to inspire ourselves. This is time to encourage. Your age does not matter when it comes to word creation. You can start today, and I'm going to give you actionable steps. I'm going to do practical things you can do. I told some people this morning, I said, fire, poverty does not die by fire. What did I say? What did I say? What did I say? What did I say? You may believe it, use your own judgment. What did I say? Use your judgment. Poverty does not die by fire. Lock up yourself. If you say poverty die by fire, it will not die, it will be growing. You know what? What I want to teach, the actionable steps. Things you can start taking action. I say, wake up. Don't be left behind. I refuse to be left behind. I don't care if some people are supposed to be here. They'll be here somewhere grumbling, complaining, and murmuring. They're already left behind. That's the truth. We are resuming our evangelism. And the purpose and the promise of God will come to pass.
Amen.
I've told you what Alexander Graham said. He said, once a door opens, we regretfully look at the door. We don't see the other pieces. What? The door that God has opened. I'm a bit small because I'm a bit slow, so that I want to take the importance. By next week, I will start deliverance. Upper week is deliverance. Please, follow us on YouTube. Follow us on Facebook. Follow us on all those areas. If your spiritual life is weak, if you play our message on YouTube or Facebook, your spiritual life will wake up. Some of the messages I'm hearing from Abuja, from Enugu, I do show him, isn't it? He's been able to be talking, even overseas. You people, you are here, you are deceiving yourself, you are taking it. It's not that you can never, we are doing our best. And I am impressed by those things. Wake up, step up, and it shall not be baffled. Praise the name of the Lord. Now, I'm still quoting from what Jeff Bezos, the father of Brazil, let me go back, say, when I am 80, and reflecting back, I want to have minimize the number of regrets that I have in my life. Listen, and most of our regrets are acts of omissions. Most of our regrets are what? Acts of omission. The things we didn't try. The things we didn't do what? The things we didn't do what? That is the thing. They asked you to go and try lesson, they didn't try it. They asked you to go and start the job, they didn't try it. This man is the richest man in the world. Am I saying the truth? Am I saying the truth?
Yes, sir.
Listen up. The things we didn't try, they pass on travel. Those are the things that, and I decided that if I didn't at least give it my best shot, I was going to regret not trying to participate in these things. Praise the name of the Lord. I think it's the one that I mean, started the internet. Praise the name of the Lord. So what are those things supposed to have started that you are not starting? And you now see somebody doing it and they are making ways, I've done this. Those are the things this man is talking about. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. So you need to take action right now. Step up. Success is not sheep. What did I say? If success is sheep, everyone will have been successful. If the road to success have been, you know, straightforward, a lot of people will have been clapping. Success is not for people that give up easily. Now do what? If you say, I am not going, you give up easily. Success is not for you. Forget about success. Forget about success. It's not for people that what? That give up easily. It is not for people that give excuses. It's not for good what? The rain is falling. The environment is not good. It's not for people that give excuses. Success comes to men and women who are dedicated. Say, I am dedicated. And I'm going to succeed. I cannot hear you. Success comes to men and women who are dedicated, not the grumblers. It is only success that can turn your mockers into your workers. They will tell you what? Those who are mocking, they become your workers. Make up your mind. We need this kind to inspire ourselves. Praise the name of the Lord. Show me a man who takes a risk. Then I will show you a man who never... show me a man who will never take risks, and I will show you a man who will never accomplish anything in life. You don't want to risk anything. Keep on sleeping over there. Keep on sleeping there. Poverty does not die by fire. It dies by calculated hard work. Is that a what? You may say poverty die. Yes, the spirit of poverty will die. But the physical aspect of it, you are there. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Ecclesiastes chapter 3 verse 11, the Bible says, God makes all things beautiful in his own time. What did I say? That's Ecclesiastes chapter 3 verse 1. What? 11. Say, God makes all things beautiful what? In his own what? Time. Brothers and sisters, if you compare the time of New York and California, they are 3 hours ahead of each other. Note that. And we need to apply this to our life. Someone may graduate at the age of 22, but waited for 5 or more years before securing a good job. Someone might become a chief executive officer at the age of 25. The person may die at the age of 50. Whereas another person may become a chief executive officer at the age of 50. He may live up to 90 years. Someone else may got married. Someone else that is not married, but no child. Someone is not married, but has a child out of wedlock. Brothers and sisters, we have different horizons. Our time horizon differs. If you look at Obama, he left the presidency of America at the age of 55, whereas Trump became president at the age of 70 or so, isn't it? If you follow me, shout hallelujah. I am talking about different time horizon for everybody. Obama left the presidency of America at the age of 55, whereas Trump became president at what? At the age of 70 or thereabout. Praise the name of the Lord. Now, if you look at it, brothers and sisters, absolutely everyone in this world, they have their own time horizon. They have their own time zone. People around you may seem to go ahead of you. Some may seem to be behind you. But everyone is running their own race. Say, I am running my own race. You are running your own race at your own time. Don't envy or mock them. They are in their own time zone and you are on your own. Some are successful in the morning, some are successful in the afternoon, while others are successful in the evening. Brothers and sisters, I want to tell you, the most important thing you are hearing from this morning is that it is never too late. It is never what? What did I say? And some of this I'm going to share with you. They will help you for those that want to become successful in life. And I want to judge If not, go to the Facebook, listen to this message over and over again. Praise the name of the Lord. We are talking about generational wealth. And if you look at our Bible, you see a man called Abraham. You see Jacob. You see Isaac. They built generational wealth. The issue is this. How do you build this kind of thing? Number one, you need to destroy what I call poverty mindset or poverty mentality. Poverty what? I cannot hear you. So many people are going about with poverty mentality. Many people are poor because they have poverty mindset. Give them $10,000. The mind is already set. The mind is what? That this kilele matoshi, kilele matoshi. The mind is already set that this is what we do for. Praise the name of the Lord. There's a mindset the rich people have. There's also a mindset of what? The poor people. It's easy to know people with poverty mentality. Rich people, they're always trusting people. Poor people, they don't trust. They suspect and they fear everything. They put their money under the pillow and it's not working for them. Praise the name of the Lord. Ask them to come and start investing in land where they will pay maybe 10,000 more for 3 years to become the owner of the land. They will run away. Poverty mentality. Praise the name of the Lord. Rich people, they find success. For poor people, they fought everything. They fought the environment. They fought the circumstances. They fought the government. Government, the price of everything has gone up. Hey, can I call it like this? They fought it. Poverty mentality. Poverty what? They fought everything. You see them discussing. Poverty mentality. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. When rich people hear there is a problem, they are looking for where to do what? How they are going to do solution there. You can sit down and look at the problems going on all over the place. If you go to IDP camp, I was told the number of pure water they are drinking a day. In the morning, in the afternoon, in the evening. You can imagine the person supplying that water, how much he's making. Government is not religious, but people are having IDP all over the place and so on and so forth. For people with this mentality, what can I do? What can I supply? Praise the name of the Lord. For you to create where you must keep poverty mentality. You must keep what? I cannot hear you. You are not talking. You must keep what? Poverty mentality. The rich people will say we, but the poor people will say them. Now the rich people now they enjoy. Look at their cars, so on and so forth. It's poverty mentality where say them. Praise the name of the Lord. I cannot hear your amen. Amen. I want you to anybody listen to me and have poverty mentality. I damage it in the name of Jesus. Amen. Be damaged in the name of Jesus. Amen. You are going here. I want to see you in an unusual. I want to see unusual transformation in your life. The last Saturday of this month, right now, we have what's called Business Master Class. Go and get your data ready between 12. Stop moving about. Stay here and see what God will do in your life. Praise the name of the Lord. Rich people, they respect time. But poor people, they think money is more important than time. Go some churches, they will start from 9 a.m. in the morning until 3 p.m. And they will drink all kinds of the blue like this. Time is money. You are not here to waste anybody's time. Anybody waste your time is wasting your destiny. All kinds of bloody meetings, you need to check it. There are rules for managing meetings. There are rules for what? They respect time. I'm supposed to be in the airport. I'm supposed to be so on and so forth. But you see, people with poverty mentality. Nothing. Time. They will sleep throughout the night. By the time they wake up, they will not even read their Bible kinds of things. Before you know it, everybody, as soon as you wake up, God is giving what? A package of 24 hours. A package of what? That 24 hours, I've told about time horizon. You are never late, you can still wake up. Obama, by 55, has retired as president of the US, isn't it? But Trump is just traveling for a second time. Praise the name of the Lord. Go to our Facebook, our YouTube. You people, you are not getting in. I'm telling you, I feel peace. It's God that put those in there. Go and listen to this message again. If you have lost 3 hours, you cannot get it again. But if you lose 3,000 naira, you can recover it. Time is money. Time is what? People with poverty mentality, they have no respect for time. Rich people, they create, but poor people, they compete. Poverty mentality. If you go to some of these direct matters, you see DSTV, flat screen television of 21,000, even in houses on top of water, water landlord, they are there. Praise the name of the Lord. Those cities, they compete. They do what? Go to the houses on water, you will see 21 inches television there. Praise the name of the Lord. Those are the... There is a difference between status and class. What did I say? You can use money to buy status. When you buy all this DSTV, maybe you went to your money, go and buy what we call it, Jeep, and so on and so forth. But we have class people. You see where they live, when they come, nobody cares what they wear. They know these people are class. In fact, the millionaire of these days, they go in jeans and t-shirt and sandals. Praise the name of the Lord. You need to have what I call financial discipline. What did I call it? You have to go and buy, no, 10 bags. Which one? $1,000. People with white creative mentality, they don't go to those things. You go and buy shoes with the right word called sole to go and show me and see those things you do. Don't worry. The church will be at the vanguard of empowering people out of COVID-19. And we are set for it. What did I say? We are set for it, for people's fortunes to change. You can start really be seeking for your December now to sack all those Shylock, what do you call it, chicken sellers. When you get a letter, get some chickens and start yelling them or goats. Don't start shaking your head. I want physical actions. Start something. I was too long and start creating business, I mean, a great business. The 5X. You are not doctor. What is the problem? You know everything by that. There's a difference between class and status. You can use money to buy status. Go around all day, you see all kinds of flower screen. DSTV, they are paying money to people in South Africa. And they will not be able to pay the children's school fees to give them quality education. Whereas every money you are sending money to South Africa, something is wrong. Poverty mentality. Poverty what? It's not a bad thing, but you get to a level where you can have money to afford it. But when you are still struggling, yes, white creation is not a spiritual dapper. With God, you want spiritual something to happen. No, you must do something. You must have physical and financial discipline. You should be able to defer gratification. Defer what? Gratification. I'm still mentioning 1.0, dealing with poverty. There are plenty. So I can't finish it today because you must have respect for time. So anytime I will let you know, I'll send you. Poverty must die, but you have the whole road to play. You have the whole what? There is a difference between what? Class and what? Status. Use money to buy status, but you what? You are class. Once you get to that level, you have the money. Everybody knows that you can afford it. You can do what? You can afford it. People knows. You can afford the treatment. You can afford everything. You're already class. They know your class. Or you are struggling. Help me by them. You need God to come. Shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. We will pray. But these are actionable things that you must go and work on as soon as you get home. As soon as you walk.
bedroom. Praise the name of the Lord. So you must work on that. As soon as you get to poverty mentality, we need to break it off. Praise the name of the Lord. Rich people, they are always looking for what they will do. Poor people, they always compete on shoes. That is poverty mentality. What can I do to make money? Make money.
Yes.
I learned at Avogadro, what do you call it? One of it is selling for 500 naira. And I have them, I have the two trees in my backyard, and they are just falling off. Oh, don't worry. But 2 days, let's gather some and carry them and sell them for what? 300 naira. So when they are keen to buy 5 naira, you use competition to chase them away. We must know how to compete. We must know to do what? To compete in the business place. Poverty mentality. Arauna wanted to give a parcel of land to David. David said, no, I am going to buy it because he had the money. Say, anything that will not cost me anything, I'm not going to give to my Lord. And then he put an altar there and the plague still. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Now, wanting people, they invest in financial education. So many people, they are not interested in financial education. All they want, and then they get them. Praise the name of the Lord. I've spoken about poverty mentality. Say mental poverty. Die in the name of Jesus. Die right now. In the name of Jesus, that in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Number two, to create wealth, you must block leakages where your resources are wasted. Block what? One of those areas, number one, gambling, Baba Jebu. Praise the name of the Lord. Gambling, Baba what? There are people coming to church. Women, go and see them. Early in the morning, they already have Baba Jebu stand. Another way you lose money is what they call borrowing. Okay? Then, you get rich quick. MMM. There's one right there. Whoever, once they bring it to you, brought to you, you can't create it. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Multi-level marketing. You need to be careful. How many people have got to that level 12 and is not enjoying money right now? Come and buy my multi-level marketing. It's another thing you have to. These are practical things. By next Sunday, I want to hear there's a change in your financial life. There's a change in what? Don't worry, I hit my leg against something. So I'm trying to manage it. So even standing on it, there's painful to me. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Blind donation. What did I call it? Somebody can say, Foundation on the website. On the website, it's asking to send money to Jigogo. Orphanage. And you are donating money. You are losing your wealth. You are losing your what? Blind donation. Praise the name of the Lord. Investing with unfamiliar people. When you go and join hands with unfamiliar people, they can make you poor. There are people that have invested with unfamiliar people that will come with sugar-coated mouth. With what? Caustic and sugar-coated mouth. They will tell you these things. Praise the name of the Lord. Giving loans to family and friends. You must find balance between giving loans to family and friends. I am not saying, I have so many things to cover, but not plenty. Plenty eternally from the book of Proverbs. Giving loans to family and friends, you have to strike a balance. It's better you give them money that you are not going to collect back. If you give loans to family, sometimes you want to collect back, it can lead to family problems. They will summon you at the family meeting, say, what is wrong with your head? So, if a family member comes, what, take this one. And some friends too, they are not trustworthy. They are not what? I'm telling you how you can lose your wealth. The leakages. That's number two. Destroy poverty mentality, block wealth leakages. Praise the mighty name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Oh, we are still looking at that. So if you want to give a lot of friends, be very, very watchful. Brothers and sisters, in the body of Christ, it's time we begin to reawake again. People have lost fortunes. Money changes people. It changes their character. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. People keep on poor in our environment because of so many things. It could be spiritual factors. Many, many years ago, when I was in university, I did an elective course in economics called, Development Economics. There was a book written by Michael Tudaro. Okay, all these books that are just talking about poverty, you know, they will not teach us how to create wealth. That is why we need financial intelligence. We need what? Financial educations. Some people too, they have a wrong belief about wealth. The Bible does not say money is the root of all the world. The love of money. 1 Timothy chapter 6 verse number 10 says the love of money. When, because of money you are not coming to church, because of money you are burdening your family, something is wrong. Something is what? Is wrong. So when money has become idol, know that you have already gone astray. Praise the name of the Lord. So you need to get it. Strike the balance very, very well. Once you break poverty mentality, block the leakages where things are going to then, you need to get out of the debt trap. Get out of what? Debt traps. The Bible says the borrower is a slave to the lender. There was a book, Debt Traps, How Developing Nations, they enter into debt traps. And as a result, developed countries, they start controlling the economy. Very, very crucial. Get out of debt traps. Don't spend your money before you earn it. And then, as much as possible, no matter how small, start looking for investments. Look out for investments. Land in your village is worth investing in. It's worth buying. There are so many land investments that they say pay in 3 years. You can make inquiries, and once you do diligent inquiries, you can start 3 years. You start small. It may be long, but eventually it becomes for own. Another thing, you may need to lower your cost of living. Reduce your cost of living. Praise the name of the Lord. When you see rich men today, they show up the slippers and t-shirts. Most of people, they have to go to match back everything. This is what they are doing. You may need to reduce your cost of living. That is the truth. And find a way of increasing your income. Find a way of what? Why are you only on one source of income? God gave you two eyes, two legs, two eyes, and so on and so forth. Why? You need to find alternative additional sources of income. Somebody said something, I think Richard Kiyosaki, read that quote, that if you're only one salary, you are a step away from poverty. What do you call it? Kiyosaki. Praise the name of the Lord. If you're only one God, you are what? A step away from poverty. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. So you must look for other sources of income. As you are getting out of this place, open up your eyes. What additionally can I lay my hands upon? Don't come back and start grumbling. What other source of income can come to me? You need to start thinking, working on that. It's going to help your life. Your attitude about your wealth must change. Money is not evil. It is the love of money that is evil. And if you listen to me, if you are not a person of character and integrity, wealth will run away from you. You can make money at once through dubious ways, but that is not the rule, it's an exemption. People will start avoiding you. Integrity will want make people to do business with you. Integrity will make people to embrace you. But if you are a person without integrity, people will run away from you. Even whatever you acquire, it will collapse. You will soon go into a leasing money that will send you to jail. Praise the name of the Lord.
So your character and integrity, they are very critical if you want to create wealth.
Character and integrity, you must work on it. You must become a better person. Say, I will become a better person.
You must become a better person in your life. I've spoken about financial discipline. Very well. It's not everything that goes that you have to buy. You need to delay gratification. Look at your future and then make sure you have reserve. When I say reserve, I mean savings.
Make sure you have savings. Very, very, very important.
Money is good. It is not evil. Money will take on the character of the owner.
Money will do what?
If the person is proud, you see. With your money, you can fly to Johannesburg. With your money, you can fly to Pretoria and look at some of the beaches over there and enjoy yourself. It's as good as that.
Money enables you to give out. When they are contributing, somebody in poor mentality, I don't have.
Anybody that has put a cost, I don't have, upon himself, I break that cost today in Jesus' name.
Stop costing yourself, say, I don't have. It's a poverty mentality.
I want to work on these things. Work on them.
They are going to help your work life. Praise the name of the Lord.
Praise the name of the Lord.
You see, there's what they call currency. Money has currents. Money has what?
And the currents flow into the direction of some people. The currents flow away from other people. I pray the currents of money will follow to that, will flow to side in the mighty name of Jesus. It will flow to side in the mighty name of Jesus. And that is where you must walk.
Another thing that will help you to create wealth is learn to negotiate.
Learn to do what?
Negotiation is a cost on its own. Negotiation skills.
They say this thing is 3,000.
Go and do sampling. Go and do market audits.
What did they say?
Go and do what?
Go for market audits.
Don't just buy in one place.
A lot of people, they bought one in a particular place. By the time they go to another place, they are selling half the price and even better quality.
As you are going to do so, wealth creation has rules.
It has what?
Stop violating the rules.
Stop what?
Your source of supply may have a cheaper source of supply.
Ladipon, they sell spare parts. Owodoni, they sell spare parts.
It is not a monopolistic market. In a perfectly competitive market, we have large buyers and large sellers.
Except it's like electricity. And electricity is no longer monopolistic as it used to be. Praise the name of the Lord.
Praise the name of the Lord.
I spoke only the last time about business risks. The only products that you sell and only there's no risk, these are food.
Okay, your tummy is coming up. You do eat anything this morning?
Eh? Praise the name of the Lord.
Those products, they have inelastic demand.
They have what?
That is, no matter the price, people will demand for them.
So, when you want to increase your source of income, try to look at products with inelastic demand.
Product what?
The business risk of product within a lasting demand, they are very minimal.
Instead, they are perishable.
Praise the name of the Lord.
That was all help Joseph.
The Egyptian people, they have food stuff, isn't it?
So there was in a lasting demand for the grains in Egypt.
You are moving. And before you know it, they took over the whole land.
Learn to negotiate, okay? Create additional source of income.
That was good.
Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. And if you want to run business, I'm still going to talk about one business. Try to make that business legal. Praise the name of the Lord. If I sign any business agreement with anybody, don't close your eyes. Don't be speaking in tongues when you are signing contracts. Say, koto, koto, koro, 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 koro. Before you know it, if you want to do business with anybody, let there be agreement between you. Okay? Henceforth, do agreement. Say, let's put it in writing so that you sign it. So that when the profit costs 800,000, the person will not be with 80,000. And you are now left with 20,000. Yeah? You are coming to pastor. Say, we started to do business together. Say, where is the agreement? You don't take anything for granted. Over the years, people have been doing something together. You've been struggling. I want to lease out this building. No agreement. Go ahead and look for potential tenants when they come. You don't sign any agreement, and thereafter, you are cheated. Say you are coming to a pastor. Pastor is not a judge. He's not a police. He's not a soldier. That's what he is. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise Jesus. I've already spoken about real estate. Now, let me tell you something. If you carry one building from here to Banana Island, just it's possible for you to carry that building and drop it in Banana Island. What do you think will happen to the value of that property? Eh? What has made the value to go up there? The land. The land. Carry the same land, carry the same building. To Oderemo, Mama, Ishara, thank you. Carry the building, no. Carry the 10-story building to Ishara, Oderemo. Or carry to my village. What will happen? Eh? It will come down. Real estate. Praise the name of the Lord. Land is what God gave Abraham. What did the Lord give Abraham? When you see building, they are made of sands, wood. Everything. If you take the authority, you just carry the building. So look, it's a lot of us who have family lands. You better prayerfully ask for your own. Prayerfully what? Eh? Ask for your own. Prayerfully ask for your own. It is not the building that changes, but the value of the land carry. That is the problem. That is the issue. To create wealth, the opportunity is still there, no matter your age. The opportunity is still there. If you look at Lagos right now, the population is increasing on a daily basis. 50% of that in Nigeria is obtained in Lagos. 60% of Nigerian businesses are in Lagos. Lagos is not, you know, complete until you own your own house in Jesus' name. Yeah. I say Lagos is not complete until you own your house in the mighty name of Jesus. Praise the name of the Lord. So if you look at it, whether by the English side, everybody seems to be to this our Gogolongo Lagos. Start thinking. Don't look at where what? Things are very, very well. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And then as you practice all these things, protect your wealth. What did I say? Protect your wealth and heritage. You see, if you are having land in your own house, your land, sometimes, you know, all the land use charge, property tax, they can be taxable. But if I have a trust company, like I have as a Adelba Foundation now, if I put my building on it, nobody will tax because it's a foundation, it's a charity organization. Some people are not listening to what they do. Go and listen to the message. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Protect your wealth. You can protect it by getting a trust. All those properties, you can have a trust company or a charity organization and put it under the house. So what is this man teaching us? I'm a chartered accountant. I want to stop. I want to do what? Nobody's asking to drop anything, but for your own life to get better, take this message and work on it. It's on your life to get water. People are waking up and are stepping up right now. Say they are not going to be left behind. The whole world is down, but people are waking up. Are you going to wake up?
Yes.
Are you going to wake up?
Are you able to hold? It is not too late. I'll be sharing all these things. Meet me October 31st. Also the second Sunday over there. You'll be hearing all these things. But go to our civilian stage. I'm telling you something now. If you have a land in your village right now, start, you know, massaging it. Before you know it, bam. The Lord will give good health in Jesus' name. The Lord will give good health in the name of Jesus. Enough of wailing. Enough of what? Enough of wailing. But money than the wailers. Stop wailing. Take action. Take action. Stop wailing. Take action. It's never too late. It's never too late. You need to take action. It's never too late. So you need to take action. Praise the name of the Lord. It's never too late. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You will build a legacy in Jesus' name. Close your eyes. You are the mighty God. The great I am. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You are the mighty God. The great I am. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Say, I shall not be a financial leper. In the name of Jesus. Pray. I shall not be a financial leper. In the name of Jesus. I shall not be a financial leper. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Say, my breakthroughs will baffle my enemies. In the name of Jesus. Shout it. My breakthrough will baffle my enemies right now. In the name of Jesus. My breakthrough will baffle my enemies right now. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. You are going to pray. Say, oh Lord, my Father. Give me that blessing that will help me to clear my debts. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray. Yes. Ask for the blessing that will help right now to clear your debts. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Say, powers of bad luck. Clear away from my life. In the name of Jesus. Powers of bad luck. Clear away from my life. In the name of Jesus. Clear away. 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 Clear away right now. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. You will rise up. And you are going to cry to God Almighty. Say, calendar of darkness. Set against my financial destiny. Cast fire in the name of Jesus. Calendar of darkness set against my financial destiny. Cast fire. Cast fire. Cast fire. Cast fire. In Jesus' name we pray. Powers are sent to slaughter my greatness. Down in the name of Jesus. Tell us now. In the name of Jesus. Tell us now. Power are sent to slaughter my greatest. Tell it down. Tell it down. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Powers are sent to liquidate my temple of breakthroughs. Be paralyzed in the name of Jesus. Power right now are sent to liquidate my temple of breakthrough. Paralyze it. Paralyze it. Shout it. Power of sin, to liquidate my temple of breakthrough. Be paralyzed in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Enemies that are mocking me, they shall receive shocking news of my breakthroughs. Enemies that are mocking me, they shall receive shocking news. Am I breakthrough in the name of Jesus? Open your mouth and pray. Enemies that are mocking me, they shall receive shocking news of my breakthrough.
Jesus, enemies that are mocking me, they shall receive shocking news of my breakthrough. Open your mouth and say it. Enemies mocking me, rest upon soca power, in Jesus' name I pray. Oh God, arise and give me the blessings that no man can oppose, that no man can counter. Oh God, arise and give me blessings that no man can oppose or counter. In the name of Jesus. See this man pray like this. Open your mouth and pray. Open your mouth. Ah, see. In Jesus' name we pray. If you want the blessing that no man can counter, raise up your hand. If I'm wanting your word, you have to see yourself. Let me show you. Let me go for you.
Oh God, arise. Oh God. And give me blessing that no man can counter. In the name of Jesus, come and give
that blessing. Amen. The Bible says the kingdom of God somewhere about it. You are deceiving yourself. It's not you, it's not God. Oh God, arise and give me blessings that no man can counter, that no man can oppose. In the name of Jesus. Does it? Does it? Give me that blessing. That no man can counter, no man can oppose. In the name of Jesus. Yes, 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 yes. In Jesus, my faith pray. Anything slowing down my financial progress, anything slowing down my career progress, anything slowing down my business progress, I kill you today. In the name of Jesus, use how to kill, demonstrate it. Prophetic, I want kill it, yes. Your financial progress. Power is not down. Kill the power, shout it. See. Use your hand as a sword. Use your hand as a sword. Yes. In Jesus' name we pray. Powers that want to bury my destiny in shame. You can do better than that. You can do better than that. There! In the name of Jesus. Powers. Power to bury my destiny in shame. In the name of Jesus. Powers. Power to bury my destiny in shame. Open your mouth and say that. Financial shame. Shame upon your children. Yes. 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 Yes, 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 yes. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Demonic ceiling. Demonic limitation. Place upon my progress. Cash fire! Your bank account. Every demonic ceiling in your bank account. Cash fire. Please pray. Cash fire. Cash fire. Cash fire. Master Posoka Parababa. Rest upon him, Baba. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Anything in my life causing financial backwardness. Shout it. Jesus, anything in my life causing financial backwardness, then in the name of Jesus, maska po soka para basababa, roske po soka para bashirebum, roske po soka para basetebum, roske po ribashinda kaunka para baska po soka bababa. In Jesus, want to pray. Say, enemies of my progress, be wasted by fire. In the name of Jesus. Come on, not to be wasted. 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 In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Any power using my pictures to curse me, die with your pictures. In the name of Jesus. precious. You see my precious? Tell it now. In the name of Jesus. Tell. Maskapo soka paraba. Respeto soka paraba baba. In Jesus, what we pray. Materials of poverty in my life. I shake them off. In the name of Jesus. Shut them up. Materials of poverty. Shut them up. In the name of Jesus. Materials of poverty right now. Shut them off. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Tell me my prayer point. Garment of sickness assigned to kill me. Cash fire. Yes. Cash fire. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Say, I shall locate my helpers. My helpers shall locate me. In the name of Jesus. I shall locate my helpers. My helpers shall locate me. Open my mouth and pray. I shall locate my helpers. My helpers shall locate me. In the name of Jesus, I shall locate my helpers. My helpers shall locate me. In the name of Jesus, I shall locate my helpers. My helpers shall locate me. In the name of Jesus, Maskaposo Kababa. In Jesus, let me pray. Say, I come out of the valley of witchcraft. That is the last purpose. In the name of Jesus, jump out. That is the last purpose. Come out for the valley of witchcraft.